Hi guys, and welcome back to SiteEnch. Another lovely day here in Fulham, and in today's video, guys, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the rebar. I'm going to show you rebar drawings, and I'm going to show you the pre-pour slab here. You can see the London, I hope you can see, they start emerging, they start being seen, all these nice funny shaped buildings like walkie-talkie 22 cheese grater and all other stuff. But today's our, we are here and residential project, and I'm going to show you how to do a proper pre-pour check and how to check where to have a look to get the job done right. So let's go, guys. So guys, before I go and I show you the rebar, show you the slab and all the stuff, just a few things I want to tell you. As you probably know, I started my Ko-fi page, and probably for people who are going to support me, I want to say thank you. And I'm probably going to be releasing some videos, some information a little bit before I put on the YouTube for these people to say thank you. Also, guys, please don't forget to follow my LinkedIn page. There are going to be some materials coming now. I had a little bit delay, but I'm very busy now here. Just show you my office here. As I said, I got a team of 4 engineers here, and I got 1 graduate here as well. He's dealing mostly with the cubes, but I want him to be more involved in construction, in setting out, in all this engineering stuff, guys. So yeah, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow the LinkedIn page, guys. Thank you again, and let's go have a look at that slab. So guys, the fixer already gone. It's nearly home time anyway, but I got a chance a few minutes to have a look and check actually the bottom steel, and I got some here finished already, the top steel here as well. And we poured already lower level in that area there. Yeah, that's the thing. So obviously tomorrow I'm gonna do a proper pre-pour, but this 10 minutes gonna give me some, maybe even more confidence what I'm gonna be checking tomorrow, as some parts I can check today. And they're probably, because we pour in tomorrow, they're probably gonna be rushed. That's how it is, guys. These RC frames, I don't really like it. We'll probably start pouring there when it's ready, and when the concrete is going to be coming, probably going to be finishing that corner, which I hate really. I want everything to be prepared before pour, and then you can inspect it, check it. If everything is missing, you just correct it. I don't like this pressure, but as I said, guys, that's the RC frames, and you have to be ready for it. But look at the nice steel here. It's all finished nice. We got the shellings there as well. The guy's doing a really good job here. I had a small issue with the shellings, with the tying of the shellings, as they sometimes move in, but the guy's getting better anyway now. We're solving these problems together. Obviously we want to get a good job done, so that's the thing, guys. You need to work together and try to find some solution. But when I'm looking at this, obviously we got the columns, we got the top steel, extra top steel. I'm looking at the extra, mostly the extra steel, the extra rebar, and I'm marking this on my drawings. I'm going to show you maybe drawing later anyway. And what I'm looking for connections as well, from, like, let's say from structural point of view. And guys, when I'm going to start my structure series, you're going to see, I'm going to tell a little bit more about the moment here, about forces and all the stuff while this slab or while the beam working. I think once you're going to understand how beam works, you can actually use it to wherever you like, and then you're going to see where to look at without even the drawing. And once you're going to go on the slab, you can see things so that you're going to be sure what this extra steel should be there, and you see it's not there. And once you're going to look at the drawing, that's going to be just your confirmation that you were right. But I'm looking at the connections also here. I want this slab to be sitting properly on the walls here. So you see there's a precast wall, a twin wall here we're using. Actually, I never worked with it before, so that's quite interesting here, guys. I'm going to show you this as well, maybe, hopefully, if I got a minute. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the precast as well, as I was using different type of precast before. So I'm gonna do some video about the precast. Well, you can see this twin wall, and then you can see the typical precast I use with the dowel bars. Obviously this is gonna be cleaned before you see some rebar sitting on the decking. This is unacceptable. Obviously this has to be cleaned, everything. But you see the slab is sitting on the walls here, obviously, and then on the columns. So that's, I want to make sure all connections are done well. And I'm going to be checking the steel, and obviously the shellings, very important thing on this type of slabs, the flat slabs with no beams. And that I'm going to be keeping an eye on tomorrow when they're going to be finishing off. But all this here, some boxes, all connections, all this, I want to make sure this is all done right. So actually here, guys, as you can see, I'm not really happy about it. I need to check the drawing here, as there is a precast wall made,
you can see, but this bit of slab is not sitting on the wall really. So I want to make sure what's on the drawing, because sometimes here the drawing shows box all the way from the wall to the wall. So that means the designer just calculated it, that it's not going to be sitting on the wall. But that's the type of thing I'm checking, guys. I want to make sure that this is right, and if it's not right, we're probably going to be drilling some bars into it to connect it. As you can see, the concrete is poured on top, and we didn't want to break any precast here.
So guys, just to quickly show you that bit here, that's what I was thinking, that there is an old box here. So actually designer assumed that slab not going to be propped on this wall here. In reality, that was changed later on the GA for two boxes here. But in terms of steel and the rebar, that was not changed. So the slab is okay, structurally it's all alright, and we are really good to go there.
But that's the type of thing I'm looking for. And as you can see, it's different here. And the precast here, you can see here, it got the ready bars inside. So that connection is provided, coming with the precast ready. And then we just splice the bars here. And that's how it works. So as I said, I'm going to check this. I'm probably going to update you on this as well. So yeah, guys, that would be slab. If I got a chance, I'm going to show you tomorrow as well. If not, maybe just a picture, some photos of it finished. They got some new columns here starting on this. This is level 6, guys, and then level 7 is the last one, is the roof. So that's level 7, they're doing the decking there. And yeah, I think that's it, guys. If you got any questions, obviously let me know. I'll try to show you a little bit more tomorrow as well, and I'm going to show you some columns as well, how my pre-pour looks.
So guys, for pre-pour inspection here, we actually, the client here, and we are using the field view. I got the tablet here, so I do the old photos. All form has to be signed and ready before pour, obviously. And then, but before even steel is here, we got the shock connectors for the balconies. So this I can check now. I check if they correct and all the stuff. And I'm going to show you the slab here, which looks really great. I'm really happy. That's how it should be looking like. But as I said, I actually show you the yesterday's slab pour, and it's a little bit crazy. And that's what the frames are like. So it's not going to be always like this, nice and ready, and you can have a look and check. That's, I would say, would be ideal world. You have a slab like this ready, all sherlings, everything is good, right? And it was a great team actually here, so I'm really happy to go and have a look. You just come in here, you look at the slab, and you know it's nice, and then just open the drawing, and it's just formality to check it. But that's it. But the guys on that block I showed you yesterday, it was a little bit crazy, a little bit rushed, and that's the problem. So guys, just to quickly show you what I got on the steel drawing here, I might show you this maybe and explain a little bit more. But what I do now, I mostly focus, so you see the orange, I mark the columns where the shearling is going to come, and we got them all here. This is all explained on the drawing, how many links, what the distance is, obviously. And I mark myself, I see this highlighted, it's an additional bar, it's a big rebar here. That's what I'm checking, obviously. I want to make sure this extra steel is in. As all the other, all the rest of it, it's and the bottom and the top, it's typically, we got 12 mil, 10 mil every 200, so you can see it's in. You don't have to check it, you won't have a time to check it with the tape and measure everything. But you want to make sure extra bars are in, you want to make sure shellings are in. This is very important things, and you want to make sure your slab actually, as I said yesterday's, actually I recorded that and I explain you and I show you that drawing with that bit I was a little bit afraid of, but it's everything is right. I want to make sure everything is sitting on the walls, and so the slab is propped where it should be propped. It's sitting on the columns, it's sitting on the walls, so structurally is all right. Obviously the balconies, as I show you the shocks here, this is very important thing as well. We want to make sure we got the proper connectors used here, and that they're going to be tied in the proper way, which I show you later as well. I think in terms of slab, that would be all I want to show you in today's video. Maybe I'm going to show you the lads are starting actually pouring there. The concrete is coming. So yeah, happy now. I just need the engineer with the laser. He's just late today, but we're going to get it. So in terms of slab, that would be all. And then I'm going to show you the columns as well. I'm going to show you how I check the column. And later, maybe at the end of this video, guys, I'm going to show you how I put it on the field view. But this is like a formality, and I explain you how to do it old school as well. So concrete is here, guys. As I said, this slab is really nice. Guys here ready, concrete in. Construction joint, it was well prepared. That balcony here, guys, We got a half fence in the slab edge. I show you this as well to make sure everything is installed. I'm maybe jump on the columns now. So guys, the column, I typically check where the shutter is here. They put in the one shutter and then I can check the cover, all the stuff. But you can see we're using these plastic distances here for the cover. I'll try to show you when it's in the shutter, but we got the lines here. So the guys got the lines here for the shutter. Obviously, I check the links, I check the correct rebar. I show you this on the drawing as well, and then I prepare the form. It's nothing complicated, really. Just want to make sure actually we got the links up to the soffit. As I found a few times here, the distance between the soffit and the last link here was too big, so I told guys to add extra link there. Obviously, top and bottom is where the force is big there, so where you need more links, and that's the thing you want to look at it when you're checking the columns. Number of links, obviously, and the main rebar. That's all about the columns, I would say. I show you one in the shutter, and then I show you the drawing as well. So guys, that's the drawing showing the column rebar here, and the column I'm looking for is C140, and it's not on this drawing. This is the sheet number 2, so I'm going to open now the sheet number 1, and I'm going to look for this column, and as you can see, some columns are similar, and I found this one, C40. It's the same as column C88. And I'm going to be checking now. That was level 5. We are looking for level 5 to level 6. So that's this part here. And as you can see here, we need 10, 16 mil bars here. And the links here. And what I said before, obviously because of the forces acting on that column, you're going to need more links at the top and at the bottom. So we got 11 links every 100 at the top and 11 links every 100 at the bottom. And only 4 links in the middle every 200. So yeah guys, that's how I'm checking. I'm just comparing this. Everything is all right as per drawing, and that's it. So guys, this slab higher here, different blocks starting again. You see the nice lines marked by the engineer. So that's obviously going to be your job when you're going to be site engineer, setting out engineer, marking the lines. You can see the box is already installed. So that's the main job here. Once the deck is open, you need to mark all the steps, all the slab edges. And all the boxes, and then obviously where we go on the edge shutter, there are going to be some half fence, all the stuff. You can see this on the drawings I'm going to provide. You can see further the guys are finishing the slab I was showing you in this video. So that's the today's one, and the yesterday's one actually I focused a little bit more in this video. That's that one there. So it's already some stuff lying on top of it. As always, one is poured, the guys bringing the stuff, bringing the shutters, making ready for another level. You see the steel there, there's already some columns lying down. They're going to be stand up probably Monday, and then we're going to pour the columns and go in one level up like here, and the same story. So it's like I said, it's copy paste guys. Just show you quickly the project here. It's a big podium there, you got a crane in the middle. You got the gas holder here. As far as I know, is the oldest gas holder in the world. I don't want to lie, but in the Europe, 100%. As you can see, this nice job there. We can see the shard, and from that block, actually, as I showed before, we can see walkie-talkie. I think it's there, but you can see all London here. So it's nice place here. So as I said, guys, that'll be all in today's video. Thank you for watching. Just don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow my LinkedIn page, guys. And if you appreciate what I'm doing, you can always support me. You can buy me a coffee, as here in these frames is very busy and I need a lot of coffee, guys. So thank you again and see you next time.